my mic off. Okay, starting from the beginning. I fixed my face because it wasn't working. And so now I'm going to show you guys how to use the Hana Tool. Just a quick little thing. So let's get started. Okay. So now, you need to export as VRM, and then we'll just wait. Once she loads up and everything, you have to look through these. You have to uncheck delete transparent meshes, because Hana Tool works with VRoid only, and if you delete any transparent meshes, then it won't recognize it as a VRoid avatar. I think that's what's going on. I don't understand. And then I like to uncheck combine hair mesh. Nezuko. Okay. I like to uncheck the combine hair mesh because, like, if you have anything like tails that you made from hair, or the ears, because the original ears used to be made from like the hair strands, then you want to uncheck this because you'll be using the bone weight transfer tool, and that won't work if your hair mesh is all one piece. And then you just hit export. Okay, now that that's done, we can exit, and I'm going to open Unity. Let me see. Oh, I don't have one for Unity. I guess I'll have to change it. So for Unity, I'm using 2019.4.31. So I'm gonna type this in. 2019.4.31.1. I know, like, at first, Unity can seem very scary, but after you do it over and over again, it's not so bad. The only thing I will tell you is that you need to save for each step of the process, just in case something goes wrong and then causes the entire file to break. So then you can always go back to the file before and only have to redo one thing. What we're going to do is we're going to import the Hana Tool. So I've already... No, I didn't download it. Just kidding. But yes, so you're going to download Hana Tool from Booth. I'll send the link again. That's downloaded. You open up your download folder and you extract all. You right click the file and extract all. And then you open up to, and I found that it works best, I think, I can't remember exactly. So there are two files you can import. One of them is Hana Tool, and then the other one is Hana Tool VRM. One of them works better than the other. If I remember correctly, it's the one that says VRM. So I'm going to drag that into the assets folder and release. I don't like how it does that. It doesn't show you all this. Well, I'll take like screenshots or something. And then, yeah, I'll take screenshots. So you hit import. To import the UniVRM, you have to update the most recent file. Okay, so here is the link. And I'll post all these links on YouTube as well. Then you drag the UniVRM file into the assets folder. Import. I don't even know where I exported my avatar. No. Okay, I'm gonna try to find that. I hope it exports the same place. Does that customers? Okay, that's okay. Take your time. So this weird thing is going to pop up and you just have to hit accept all. Okay, so then you find wherever you downloaded your VRM file. Make sure you don't forget, like I did. And then you... Wait, no. I did that wrong. Does that work? I've never done it like that. My brain is fried. Okay, so... Yeah, that works. Yeah, it is a VRM file. Okay, so I guess you can just drag your VRM file into the assets folder. So now here's the VRM. And you drag that onto the scene. That's funny, I had no idea. I'm lagging a little bit. I hope I'm not lagging in stream. Okay, so now that the avatar is in here, you go to Hana Tool, and I forgot how to do this actually. And she still has, okay, well, I'm gonna do, you need to do, not the builder, but you need to do the reader first. Okay, so this is the part that I was having trouble on. I didn't know which one to use. So you have to drag the face onto here. And then version I had. Okay, so yeah, if you get an error, that means that it's not the right one. Mine's a female base. Okay, so that one worked. So mine was version 100. So honestly, I just keep picking these, one of these, until one of them works. Okay. Stuffed tutorial. So yes, you drag the face of your avatar onto the where it says skin mesh render of the Hana Tool, and then you pick which one it is. I think the SRANDIPAL is for VRChat or something, but if you're using it for VSeeFace, it should be one of these, I think. Okay, so after you do that, then you want to go to Clip Builder, drag your avatar onto it. And I already did this once, so I kind of messed up, but let's go ahead and do it again. Okay, so now you can see all the blend shapes. So I think... Yes, yeah, so now you've seen her making all the different facial expressions. Some of these are not working. The squint isn't working. Let me see. Neutral? Left blink, right blink. Fun. Sorrow, surprise. Look up, look down. I think these didn't even work when I was doing it on my avatar, but my avatar looks on all directions. So these should be fine. These eyebrows, I'm not sure why they're not working. Let me check. So right eyebrow, that's this one. Okay, it's not, the slider isn't moved. Okay, you can kind of see it. Her hair's in the way. I'm gonna remove her bangs for a second. Okay, there we go. So now we can see her face. She's gonna look funny, but you can see her face. Let's go back to the eyebrow. Brow down left. This is the left eyebrow. We want it to go down. Right here. Then we just move them. And you can move it as far as you want. So I think maybe right there. Maybe around 50. What are you working on, Midnight? I'm doing a tutorial for the Hana Tool. This is probably as far as I'm gonna go today, honestly. But it's so that the avatar's facial expressions will work better with the iFacial mocap. Well, I use iFacial mocap. I mean, there are several applications you can use, but basically, her facial expressions are a lot better. And this is probably going to break Unity, but okay. Okay. Like, if you notice, my avatar has much better face tracking. Tutorial for OG Midnight? Cool Midnight? No. I don't know. I don't know if she's coming back, honestly. I have her as an option. I'll have her as a redeem. I don't know if I already did that. Do I have her as a redeem? I think I did, right? Got her a while ago. Let me see. I don't have it. I thought I had it. I'll make sure to add it though. But yes, that's what we have so far. So you'll want to go through all of the facial expressions. You'll want to go through all of the facial expressions and fix them to your liking. So I'm just going to save. And then we can start playing a game. Hello. Okay, so today I'm going to be kind of quickly redoing the tutorial from last time, because it was kind of scuffed, and since I'm going to record the last bit, I should do it again anyway. And then import, and then I'm going to drag in the VR. UniVRM. Let me see if I can find my avatar. I don't remember exactly where I imported her. Okay, she's right here. Okay, so then we hit accept all.
I'll lock this in.
Okay, so now once that's done, you can simply just drag your VRM into the assets folder. And then you wait again. There we go. Okay. So now you can drag her into the assets folder. And then you go to Hana Tool, and the first one you want to do is the reader. Okay, so for this one, like I said earlier, you could just keep picking until one works. So mine, I know there's this one now. And then let me make sure. I don't remember if you drag the face in first, or you drag in the whole avatar. Okay, so you drag the face in first. So you drag the face into the skin mesh render, and then you hit read Blendshapes. Once that's done, you can exit, and then you go to Hana Tool, Clip Builder, and you drag your avatar into the avatar. Oh, it even says avatar. So if it says skin mesh render, then you drag in her face. If it says avatar, then you drag in her entirely. That's a new VRoid. I don't know what these other ones are. Well, this is the old VRoid. But I don't know what this is. I think I heard someone was using it for like VR face tracking. But I don't know how that works. I've not touched it. I don't have one. Doing this one step at a time. Okay, so now that that's done, when you go to Blendshapes, you'll see all of these Blendshapes. Okay, so this one. And you'll go through them and make sure they all look alright. These look up, look down, look right, look left. You just leave them as is and they should work fine. So surprise, sorrow, brow left. Okay, so see how this one is too low? You'll want to scroll here, scroll down to see face, and you adjust the slider to like how far down you want it. And it's about 50. I like using like multiples of 10 or 5. So you're going to go through all of these and fix every single one of them. And there are lots of little sliders you can play with. What I have noticed though is that you don't need, like if you want fangs, because fangs are over here, you don't need to move the slider for each facial expression. And if you do, it'll actually overlap over all the other things that are in every single different facial expression. So make sure you don't do that. And that's pretty much it. So then you can go to click on your avatar and then go to export. And then you can just export her so you don't move it. Click here. And that's it. Okay, so now let's play some games.